Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I would like to show you how to do random forest regression. As we know, the regression we can use a simple linear regression or multiple linear regression, but we have another method like random forest regression, but it could be better or not. So if we know the how to do, it's okay to compare between the two, three methods. So before we start, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. The first one, as we know, we could import the packages like pandas, numpy, seaborn, matplotlib library, scikit-learn. Okay, here we use the Python Jupyter notebook. Okay, quick run. The first line, second line, and the second part is import the dataset. Oh, sorry, I do wrong here. Okay, no worry. It doesn't matter. Okay, the first one I use the data from the Bracer tutorial is the raw data. It is the CSV file like. Okay, we can click run here. Okay, one thing I would like to give you, like when we do the regression, we don't need a string function like name, genus, anything like not numeric. We don't need, for example, order, conservation, and name, what, etc. But what we do, we could do the data preparation. Okay, this third part is data preparation, and I drop any NA. It means that no data, but I select in place equal true because I return it back to the DF or our dataset. So click run here, and the first DF is I drop string function or sleep cycle because. When I look at inside the data, it so many nonce. Okay, I don't need, and then I select the I drop also the sleep total because I need, because we the purpose of this study, we would like to predict sleep total. And then I give the y variable like sleep total, but select only sleep total. X variable is mean independent variable. Y variable here it as the dependent variable on response or okay. After that, I select the test size is 0.3. It mean 30%, but you can select another one if you have more data set here, 0.4, 0.25, 0.35, etc. here, and I click run. Okay, after that, after we prepare data do preparation, we can do the model like random forest regression. So here an estimator as the number of tree we need. Okay, I select 100 tree to show you first, and click run and fit data, and we can check the output. Here, because we have 20 variable, we set 70% as the train set, and we have 6 data sampled as the for prediction. Like okay, actually I could show you okay here. APE. Okay, we have here hint. And ndf.share. Okay, we have 20 samples, and we have five column. But for train, we have 14 because 14 is 70% of 20, and we remain 6 as the prediction. So, okay, after that, I can change it as the data frame here, and select the Y valid, which means to check how our accuracy here. After that, we go to section plot by using a scatter plot. Here, X axis as the predicted variable, predicted data. Y axis is actual data. We can compare by using the R square like this. Oh, our R square as the 0.88888. It's okay, it's fine, but we can change a little bit like tuning data. Okay, we can select 100 trees. Run the same procedure here. Not change, and then we the main point is here now 0.88. okay, but we change it as the 100 trees, the result is less than previous one. It mean that 100 is fine to select to set that to the date to our model. So I think you can learn something in my tutorial. You can select or set up anything here by you could know what it inside, like search in Google like sklearn, I think random forest regression here. So here is all is completely explained. So what it is, the parameter and what does it mean, and etc. Here you can learn from here, and then you can go back and set your data, your model. So I give you as a guideline for data. So it could be help less or more, but I hope you enjoy the tutorial. So thank you for watching. If you like my such kind of this tutorial, you can like, subscribe, whatever you like. So see you in next tutorial. Thank you. Bye bye.